Hello, my name is Richard Stanley. I'm with the Legacy Foundation, and we've been promoting the use of biomass briquettes for about 15 years in different parts of the world. Some of the results of that experience have suggested that we needed a more portable press, especially one which can be used by a smaller group of people in perhaps more in the urban areas. So here's what we've come up with, and this will soon be available online. The plans on how to make and how to use a press will be available along with our other products and services. The press is meant to be portable. It doesn't weigh very much. It's, I think, worth maybe 25 pounds, something like that. It comes in such a way that it can break apart and stand alone. It has two holes in the back. You see these little keyholes here. And these can fit into a wall and hook on if you need to tie it. If you have no such structure and you want to use a control, then here is the stand. And the stand is held together like so. These legs swing out to lock the stand in place. As you can see right here, just with a kick of the foot. Now you have one integral unit. Okay? So now, let's proceed to make a briquette. Now, I'm not going into the process by which you prepare this mix. That's fairly well known. It's tested already, so it fits in your hand. I fill it this way. The idea is to recapture most of this wasted water. So I'm going to go ahead and fill this up to that point, huh? Okay, then what we'll do is release this lever here. Now we begin the ratcheting process, and watch the teeth catching here, taking a successive bite out of the metal further down. As it does, I'm moving the piston down. I'll go slowly. I don't want to squirt too much water in this case. Okay, now we're getting tighter. One more, and we're fairly tight to the end of the stroke. Okay, now I just simply release the tension on that handle. I release the handle. This pops down. Now with the next stroke, what's happening is that the briquette will start to fall out. And there you are. You can blend in cedar. You can blend in pine needles to suit the aroma that you might want for the fire. But it supplants the needs of cooking for people in the third world in a very serious way. It takes about two of these, maybe three, per person per day on average. And that replaces about a kilogram of firewood. That's about 2 pounds of firewood per person per day. And these are sold. The idea here is to generate an income, generate a useful project, so that people could have income and sell them to the local markets to replace the demand for fuel wood and charcoal. Okay, thank you. And that's it. Okay, we'll see you tomorrow for another day of briquette making. Goodbye.